Hello, and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be looking at lipids, and specifically base hydrolysis, which that's all about saponification, meaning that we're going to be making soap. So how does this work? Well, if you have a lipid or a fat that you have from maybe like the store or from different animals or all kinds of different products, you can turn it into soap. Now, how exactly does that work? Well, let's say if I had a triacylglycerol, just like the one here. This is what we refer to as a fat or an oil. So just like vegetable oil or butter or different fats that you find on meat, that's kind of the same general idea. Now, if you add a strong base to it, so let's say lye, for example, or sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, and you're to add those under very, very intense heating conditions, you can break it apart, kind of like what your body does. Your body puts it through acidic conditions and breaks it apart. But this we want to do through basic. So when that happens, you're going to make glycerol. In this case, the fatty acid is going to become a salt of the fatty acid. So saponification, just to kind of do the official definition, is when a fat is heated under basic conditions to create glycerol and the salts. Now, the cool thing about this is how all the different salts are formed that you can find in your house. So, for example, if you have a bar of soap laying at maybe the sink, or in your shower, that was essentially made by adding sodium hydroxide or lye to that, which that was originally a saturated fat, so all single bonds, and that's used to make a hard soap. So if you have any of the ones that are shaped like different things, that's because it was a hard soap or saturated, because it was originally more of a solid before it was being added. Now, if we add a little bit of a weaker base, slightly weaker, like KOH, and if this is added to an unsaturated fat, this is how you make liquid soap. So like what you find maybe by your dishwasher or potentially like your shampoos and conditioners and things like that. So like, for example, if you have like a coconut shampoo or sometimes they have avocado shampoos now, all those are from oils that are unsaturated. So that's a little bit of a fact. Now, how does this reaction work? Well, the whole idea is, let's say if I have this particular triacylglycerol, what you're going to be doing is breaking apart by adding 3 moles of NaOH under heat, just like I said before. And the whole idea with this is that, well, we're going to break it into its different fragments. So if we copy and paste this down below, we're going to be cutting it with our little water scissors, just like how we did with our previous hydrolysis video. But the only difference here is, so if I were to cut it, where is it weakest at? Well, it is weakest right where the ester bond is for all of these structures. So we are going to cut it right at this carbon-oxygen bond because the oxygens are pulling in both directions. So it's ready to be broken under the right conditions, and basic is just right. So when that happens, right, we're going to be pulling that into its two pieces. And now when that pulls, well, one side is going to be our H from our NaOH, right? So if we kind of like look at this structure and think NaOH, I like to think of this isn't completely the right organic-y way or mechanism way, but it makes it easy to remember is that with this one, we're gonna have two fragments, right? There's H and then NaO minus Na plus. So we have two charges on this. Maybe we'll use a different color here. So with each of these, so once I erase the purple or erase the little X's here, just like so, we're going to put our salt compound because this is going to be a fatty acid salt on the right-hand side. So we have our O minus, then Na plus on each of these different structures. So Na plus, O minus, Na plus. So this is a fatty acid salt, okay? Which, just as a reminder for if you don't remember your organic, this is also known as a carboxylate, okay? So it has an A-T-E ending to refer to the salt form. Now, the other product is a glycerol that forms, and these are your two different products in your final reaction. Okay, so when we look at the complete reaction, just like so, you're going to have your big fatty acid, and it gets split into the fatty acid salt and glycerol. I hope this video helped. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit that like and subscribe button, and I hope to see you all in the future. Bye now.